character trip. Does it mean it's an initiation somewhere, the movie?
Well, without giving it too much away, I mean, anything can happen in the end.
Sans trop donner d'indices, tout peut arriver à la fin.
Lars.
Fuck me, Lars!
Hola. I'm just visiting your beautiful country. I'm not saying anything about the ending.
Moi, je visite juste votre magnifique pays. Je dis rien sur la fin du film.
Comme une lion.
The fact that the character is called Trip means it's an initiation somewhere, and he's gonna go through because of your music, because of what it does to people. Do you think that?
Well, I think the point is that there really is no point, you know, and I think that so often when you do these kind of projects, you have to sort of, you know, carve it out in stone and explain everything. And I think, you know, the message of Metallica is that, you know, all our friends and our fans should figure out what they want Metallica to be for themselves. You know, James Hetfield's lyrics have always been very ambiguous, very open to interpretation. I don't think James wants to explain his lyrics. I certainly don't want to explain his lyrics. And I think that when Nimrod Antal wrote this great script and that this story, the reason we picked it was because it fit Metallica so well in that it is very ambiguous and it is very open to interpretation. So everybody's asking, what happens to Trip? What's in the bag? What's it's all supposed to mean? And I think every person that sees this movie should be able to walk away from this movie with their own version of what it is that happens. If I go to the Pompidou and see a great Dubuffet painting or a, you know, a Pollock or something like that, I want to walk away from that experience making up, you know, my own version of what that painting means. I don't need Dubuffet or Pollock to tell me what it means or a critic to tell me what it means. I want to figure it out for myself. And I think that's when art works the best, is when people can kind of relate to it in their own way. And I think that this movie is the ultimate in that.
Traduction.
Le but du film, en l'occurrence, c'est qu'il n'y ait pas de but. Quand on fait un gros projet comme ça, en général, on est obligé de tout expliquer et que tout soit bien carré dans tous les sens. Et ça ne connaît pas vraiment avec Metallica. Quand vous regardez par exemple les paroles de James Hetfield, elles sont toutes ouvertes à l'interprétation. James déteste expliquer ses paroles et je ne me permettrai sûrement pas moi aujourd'hui d'essayer de les expliquer, mais c'est exactement la même chose quand je vais dans un musée et que je vois un beau tableau de Dubuffet ou de Pollock. J'ai envie qu'il soit ouvert à l'interprétation. J'ai pas envie que quelqu'un me raconte ce que le tableau veut dire ou qu'un critique d'art me raconte ce que le tableau veut dire. C'est ce qu'on fait avec Metallica, c'est ce qu'on a essayé de faire avec ce film.
Voilà. Maintenant, short questions. Who is the leader of Metallica? Lars.
That guy right there.
Le mec, juste là.
Lui. And has been for 32 years.
Ça fait 32 ans que c'est leader.
And could you describe the ones who are not here? Lars and Kirk, do you want to describe James or Robert? Give us some clues about them. If they are not here today, describe James Ford.
Est-ce que vous pouvez décrire un petit peu vos collègues dans le groupe?
That's
James
too
Rob.
Easy.
That's a loaded question. We can either be here all night or I can give you like two sentences.
C'est compliqué, soit on est là toute la nuit, soit je vous donne deux petits.
I want to hear this. But Kirk, come on.
Describe Kirk and Rob. Describe James and Rob. Écris
James et Rob, vas-y.
Okay, two sentences?
Okay. En deux phrases.
James is tall and blonde.
James tall and blonde. Blond et grand.
And Rob is
short Mexican.
Short brown.
He's not here.
Il est petit et marron. Voilà.
That's the short end.
We have four very different personalities in Metallica. I think that most of our friends and fans have sort of figured that out by now. You know, I think the great thing about Metallica is that we continue to evolve as people, and we're not stuck in one way, and we don't feel that we have to be one way all the time. It's 32 years, and we continue to evolve as people, as musicians, as artists, as parents, as and so on. I think the best thing that happened to Metallica over the last 10-15 years is that we all had children. And because when we all had children, Metallica became a better place because of that. Because the main thing in our lives now is taking care of our children and our families. And Metallica is more fun and there's a better place. Metallica is almost like an escape now, where the four of us go, and so we all bring something different to Metallica. You know, Robert is very balanced and incredibly gifted musician who actually is the one that the three of us look to often for, you know, chords and how did that go and what was this. He does a lot of homework and does a lot of thinking about the music, so the rest of us don't have to. And James is obviously, you know, the most gifted guitar player on this planet. Every time James Hetfield, you know, tunes his guitar or turns his guitar on, he writes like five riffs. So we have to make sure
riffs.
We have to make sure
amazing
that Spider Dan's always recording, and that James is always recorded. And it's my job to kind of go through those riffs and pick out, you know, the best ones or whatever. But he's so prolific and he's so incredibly talented, and is also, I think, in the last few years has gotten a little more humble and is just continues to kind of be a greater and greater person to be around. And I think that the temperature in Metallica continues to get better and better. We get along better and better as we grow older, and we're more and more appreciative of what we have between us. We're more appreciative of what we have with our friends and fans. Our eyes are more open. And dare I say this, there's a lot of love around Metallica these days, and we try to take every moment of that in. Now, Pierre, try to translate every one of those words.
Alors, ceux qui connaissent bien Metallica.